Okay, so who would like to kick us off? Any takers for a live one? Or should I start with a video?
Oh, sorry. No, I said, well, if you want, because I've once again, it's pub night, so I need to sneak away relatively early. And
pub calls, I get it.
I'm wearing all Prelly's bloody clothing here. Naked.
Okay, well, yeah, Neil, if you're ready, then you can kick it all off for us.
I can't get near the bloody thing. Ready is a kind of like a bit of an odd term, really. Ready.
Oh, sorry, never... just giving you a lovely view of my armpit. I'm sorry about that.
Okay, couldn't smell it from here.
It's probably just as well. It's been scorchio down in London today. Yeah. I don't know about, have you had decent weather where you are?
Yeah, I've had decent weather for about a fortnight now.
That's good. It's hot today. It's actually warm. I had to tackle a child, well, not literally tackle a child today in the playground. There's a child standing out in the, it's like 25 degrees in the playground, and this child is standing in his full coat zipped up. It was a fire alarm, so the fire alarm went off and we're all outside, and I'm looking at him going, why have you got your coat on? He said, I was cold. I said, you can't be cold, I can see sweat on your face. Honestly, yeah.
You need a doctor.
Oh dear. Okay, Neil.
Mark, well, I'm trying to think what to do. I said I'd start first, but I'm going to. Oh, bloody hell, woman!
Sorry, I just need to mute myself, don't I? I'll shut up.
Please.
It's not the BBC, is it? You can tell.
No decorum here.
I'll sing a wee song. This is called Book of Love. I don't know if I've sung it before. It's by a band called Magnetic Fields. But it's not sung like this because the lead singer is kind of like a baritone Tom Waits. So it's a bit of an odd one.
Neil, can I pause you a minute?
What?
Neil,
what?
Make sure your original sound is turned on.
Is it sounding terrible? Is it?
Yeah. It's dampening the guitar.
I'm gonna say, like, if it sounds terrible, that's because it probably is. Wait a minute. This bloody sun thing. Hang on. Is it?
Long and boring, written very long ago. It's full of flowers and heart-shaped boxes and stuff we're all too young to know. But I love it when you bring me things. You should bring me when it rains. I love it when you bring me things. You should bring me when it rains. You should bring me when it rains. You should bring me when.
That's a great song. It's a really, really good song. I like that, Neil. That's really good. Who did you say it was by?
An American band called Magnetic Fields.
Right. Okay.
They are
not very, a band I've heard of.
No, they are very, very strange. But I heard somebody else had sung that song, and I thought, well, yeah, that sounds nice. I listened to the original, I thought, God. The original's got like a... He sings like a... The book of love is long and... No, have a look on YouTube like that. It's unbelievable. Like, it really is.
Right. It's a good song, though. It's a great song.
Yeah.
The longest song on the album, because the album's called 69, and it's got 69 tracks on it. And that's the longest one.
It's like... It's an album of ideas, really.
It's all over in about a minute and a half. No, I'm not going to say it.
Has anybody heard the Solway Spaceman by Slipknot?
Yes.
And it's I was trying to be cool and groovy with a young choir member. I was saying, hey, you know, what do you think of Slipknot, the Solway? She says, I have no idea what they're on about, but I love them.
Oh dear. Right, so I've got a slight plan of where we go. So we're going to do a video next. And then, Dad, do you want to do one of yours?
Yeah, I will do.
Okay. Yes. And then I was thinking another video and Sandy.
Tell me where to stop if this is all too much, but it's.
And then another video and Ian, and then round again until somebody else joins in and we change the pattern a bit.
Sounds good.
Yeah. Okay, so video-wise, I haven't got a clue. I've got a vague idea, but I haven't had a chance to really look at all of the things that have been submitted. So I'm going to kind of pick something and go with it. So let's have a look. What have we got? I know I've got two from you, haven't I? Colin, I think.
Yep, two from me.
And I've got four from Jeff. I've got one from Tony. I'll leave that till a bit later if he manages to join in. So actually, do you know what? I think I might start with one from Jeff and we'll see how that goes. So this one is a short one. Jeff, did you want to say anything about this one? It's the Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Oh, you're muted.
In a strange way, no disrespect, Colin, I was rather hoping you might not be here tonight because my first one is me on ukuleles. Absolutely no disrespect. And I'd rather my video wasn't played than
you. I'm sure you'll put me to shame.
I don't think so, mate. I really don't think so. I don't achieve a sound like you, but this was an old video. I did it quite a while ago when I first started to play the ukulele, to be honest. So, anyway, yeah, it's just a little instrumental version of Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Okay, here we are. That's super.
Yeah. Nothing wrong with that. That's good.
Yeah, lovely.
Oh, sweet. Unlike me.
is this what the shirt is in aid of?
I've just got this to distract my the internet radio shows, because as I say, there's a camera, so it's kind of it's trying to distract from my maybe uncombed hair or untidy office. You know, it's the good carpet principle because the ceiling's crap, or vice versa.
Oh dear. Okay. Right, Dad, would you like to give us one of yours?
Yeah, my offering this month is I've done a fair old bit of work on getting this 1944 French play down to a sort of acting length and lack of wordiness. So I've cut loads of stuff. But it looks as though any chance of I've been putting it on and kind of receding into the distance. So I thought, you know, I might share bits of the script with you, if that's all right. It was a play by a guy called Jean Henri. If you've done A-level French, you'll know Antigone. But in fact, in England, we pronounce it Antigone. So shall I actually just do some of the background stuff first? Because that's where he starts, really. He starts by talking about the city of Thebes in ancient Greece.
Can you get a little bit closer to your microphone?
Well, I can do, yeah.
Or bring your microphone closer to you.
Is that any better?
Still really quiet.
Oh, all right. Do I need to go up a bit?
Yeah, that's a little bit better, yeah.
Right, so if I lean forward. So, yeah, so he has what he does. The French at this time were busy putting a load of the kind of Greek myths into their own theatre thing. But as you know, Greek tragedy usually has a chorus, so a lot of this explanation would be in the mouth of a chorus. So as I say, it's Thebes after the death of Oedipus. So you remember, killed his father and married his mother, both unwittingly, and so therefore has been very unfairly called and had the Oedipus complex named after him by Freud, when in fact, he did all of this totally without realising what he was doing. But after he was dead, his two sons, because he had four children, Eteocles and Polynices were his two sons, and then he had two daughters. I'll talk about one of them later on. But Eteocles and Polynices were the sons of Oedipus, and when he died, they were supposed to share the kingship of the sort of kingdom city of Thebes, one year at a time. I'll do a year and then hand it over to you, and I'll do a year and then hand it back to you. Well, of course, Eteocles came first, and then when he finished his year, he didn't want to hand over. So Polynices, his younger brother, said that it should be his turn, and they had a civil war. They fought each other. They both of them died outside the walls of the city, and Oedipus's brother-in-law Creon had to pick up the kingdom. So Creon had originally been nothing more than Oedipus's brother-in-law. He was Jocasta's brother, and he was different. He loved music. He bought rare manuscripts. He was a kind of art patron. But now he's king, and it's his job to unite the people who've been divided by the civil war, because they really just took sides with Polynices or with Eteocles. So one of Creon's first things, he's issued a decree that Eteocles, he's going to be honoured and buried as a hero of the state. And that Polynices, body is going to be left on the battlefield to rot, and that no one must give him a religious a burial. And that's about the worst punishment you can get. Anyone found trying to bury the body will be put to death. And then somebody does try to bury the body, and it turns out to be Creon's future daughter-in-law, Antigone, who was married to, or engaged to be married to, Creon's son. So that's really where the play starts. Do you want to know the first? I've got four speeches of Creon's that kind of tell the story. When Antigone is first brought in front of him, he says, "You thought I'd have you killed? Hand you over? And you over to be killed? I've other plans for you. You're going to marry Haemon, and I want you to fatten up a bit so that you can give him a sturdy boy. Let me assure you that Thebes needs that boy a good deal more than it needs your death. You'll go to your room now and do as you've been told, and you won't say a word about this to anybody. You do realise that it will be impossible for me to avoid putting you to death if there is any chance I can save you. Only if you keep this to yourself and give up your crazy purpose. 5 minutes more and it will be too late." That's me for now.
Excellent. Look forward to hearing a bit more of that.
Sorry, I'm slow. I'm muting you. I was saying I've got a different system. No, that was just really good. Sorry, mate.
So this is a play that's being considered for the John Peel Theatre next year or the year after or sometime. Oh, have you muted yourself? You're muted, Dad.
I've done my usual and reduced it from over 22,000 words to under 10.
Right. Okay, excellent. Thank you for that. Now, we're going to come to another video, and then Sandy, we'll come to you after that. So this one, should we go for one of yours, Colin? Let's see. Which one would you like to go first? Say that one again.
Neil Gaiman.
Okay. I don't know if it's just me. We're losing you a bit. Wi-Fi sounds a bit dodgy, but it could be mine. Mine's being a bit spotty. Okay, here it is. Did you want to say anything about this one?
Yeah. Okay, well, I don't know if anybody knows who Neil Gaiman was, but for the benefit of those who don't, he was back in the, what was it, late 17th, early 18th century. He was... one of the founding fathers of Scottish fiddle music. He wrote lots of jigs and what have you. The story has it that when he died, he was so upset that he went against his ring. He was persuaded to come out of retirement and perform. Allegedly, is what he came out with. But one of the problems is, like, his children apparently, so he didn't get his son. She got Mr. Wall real and I've got a lament, so work that out for yourselves. Anyway, it's like a little tune.
Okay. I don't know if it's just me. Is anyone else hearing Neil fine, or are you hearing him broken up as well? Okay.
Very broken up, yeah.
Yeah. Sorry, you started off absolutely fine and then we lost you. Just play it.
I don't know what's going on there, but just
it does. It sounds like slightly sketchy Wi-Fi, so I think it's yours since it's for everybody. But okay, so yeah, this one, the lament, I'll play it now. Here we are. That's beautiful.
Sweet. Sweet. That's wonderful. That's how a bloody ukulele should be played. That's lovely, lovely, Colin. Yeah.
Yeah,
you never disappoint, gorgeous. Mate. You never disappoint.
So that's possibly a good time to mention, because we've all said it many times on the open mic night, that Colin should start putting together a CD. So for this concert in October, Colin, I'm going to hold you to your offer of having a CD for sale in the theatre foyer. So basically we've got so everybody has agreed now to the concert, so I'm going to be going full steam ahead. I'm still fixed on a name yet for this concert, but I'm going to be going full steam ahead on organising that for October, that date that we discussed. And Colin has said he would like to contribute to that with a recorded CD of his thing. So I know I'm going to be first in the queue for that. And hopefully we'll see you there as well. No pressure at all.
In the
comfort of your own living room kind of thing. Yeah. But yeah, absolutely. We'll need to get that sorted, definitely, because I know there's lots of people lined up for a CD. The other thing I was going to mention, actually, and since I'm sort of talking concerts, I might as well, is I'm in the process of booking quite a lot of concerts at the moment. So I don't know if you're aware, I'm kind of trying to launch this Folk at the John Peel, because since Carlisle Folk and Blues Club closed down a few years ago, there aren't many folk venues in this part of Cumbria. I say this part of Cumbria, sitting in London, but you know what I mean. My mission was to try and see if we could rectify that. So I have been busily learning very quickly how to book artists and who to talk to and the language of all of that. So far we have 4, I think, confirmed and another 2 potentials in the pipeline. So we've got Charlie Dore coming on the 28th of September. So tickets are already on sale for that one. We then have the brilliant John Kirkpatrick coming and doing his Caroling and Crumpets show on the 8th of December. That one, we've already sold 12 tickets for that out of the 90 that we've got available. So that's looking like it's possibly going to... Well, I want to sell them all out because that's how we'll keep doing them, basically. Oh. But then we've got The Ha booked, which is a kind of a young up-and-coming band from Ireland. They're booked in for the 4th of February. So that's quite an exciting one. And then I've got Damien Barber and Mike Wilson coming in with... coming in on the 16th of March, I think it is. So they are then doing a gig. And I'm also currently in negotiations with Bryony Griffiths and Alice Jones and Catherine Roberts and Sean Lakeman to see if we can get them at the theatre as well. So it's building to be a really, really good programme for next end of this year and next year. So, spread the word if you can, because I need to get bums on seats and fill the theatre in if we're going to keep it going. So, yeah. Sorry, Dad.
One thing there that you, that Charlie Dore is coming with Julian Lippman.
Oh, that's right. Yes. Sorry, I should have mentioned that.
And, Ian might know, but he wrote several of the really good songs on the Wintersmith CD.
Yeah. So, yeah. Formerly Steel Ice Span, I think, wasn't he?
Yeah, he's been in, well, he was in Wintersmith when they did Steel Eye when they did Wintersmith CD.
Yeah.
He's also written stuff like I Will Wear Midnight and...
Yeah. So if you've got any friends that are into folk music or that might be interested in any of those concerts, let them know, spread the word, because I want to make it a regular thing. But obviously... if we don't sell out the tickets, then we're going to struggle to book the artists. So we need to fill the theatre. It shouldn't be too big of an ask with 90 seats and with not much else in the way of folk concerts in this area. So I'm kind of hoping that we can pull in a decent audience. But, yeah, spread the word for us, please. And if you fancy it, book some tickets and come and join us. So, okay, we're going to come to Sandy now.
It's a shame that he's so far away. I'd love to see Kirkpatrick.
Absolutely.
I've got one of his old tapes of that.
But what, of Caroling and Crumpets?
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
I think it was actually a tape.
Wow. But,
anyway.
What are they?
The things that jam up in the dashboard of your vehicle.
Anyway, I've actually got a brand new one here, if anyone wants to buy it.
Oh, my. You stick it on two pencils and turn it around.
Oh, I remember those days. Oh, I certainly remember that, Sandy.
Anyway, I haven't sung anything folk-ish for a long time. I'm singing with a championship women's barbershop chorus. And so I've got 6 songs to learn for them. Anyway, I've got a song here by, it's written by Tim Erickson, and I got it on a CD by Liza Carthy. So it's called Friendship. Friendship through every willing mind opens up a... Sorry, I'm going to put my glasses on. I can't read. Denial, denial. Friendship through every willing mind opens a heavenly treasure. There may the sons of sorrow find sources of real pleasure. See what employments men pursue, then you will know my words are true. Friendship alone unfolds to you sources of real pleasure. Also the joys which false esteem, fading and transitory. Mirth is as fleeting as a dream, or an elusive story. Luxury leaves a sting behind, wounding the body and the mind. Only in friendship can we find pleasure and solid glory. Happy the man who has a friend formed by the God of nature. Well may he feel and recommend friendship for his creator. Then as our hands in friendship join, so that our social powers combine, ruled by a passion most divine, friendship for our Creator. Friendship through every willing mind opens a heavenly treasure. There may the sons of sorrow find sources of real pleasure.
Ah, fabulous. Thank you, Sandy. Hello. Have missed you in the open mic. And Steve, but Steve's off golfing.
He's off playing golf, yeah. And it's the first day in about 2 weeks that we've actually had spits of rain.
Oh, nothing really? Capable.
Nothing to put the damn forest fires out either.
I was going
to
say, have you got forest fires again where you are?
Well, there's up on the island, there's a big one out, do you know where Tofino is on the west coast there? It's, yeah. You can't even get there.
Oh, gosh.
The road is closed.
Wow. And, yeah.
There is a detour, but it's a rough logging road, and it's a 4-hour trek, and there's no cell phone coverage, there's no gas, there's no washrooms, there's no corner store.
Gosh.
And there's already been an accident, so...
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Stay home.
Yeah.
Sandy, sorry, it really is very lightweight and flippant, perhaps. Is your hair actually that colour? Because it looks really brilliant.
Yes. Yeah. It looks like... My hair is normally... Well, yeah, I've dyed it. It's blue.
Yeah, it's great. Actually, it sort of matches. You've got a book on your shelf there next to Erebus. Yeah. And it kind of matches that, you know. Yeah. No, it looks really nice.
Yes, well, it's good to have you back, it really is. So I'm glad you're here. Okay, so we're going to do another video and then Ian. there's a leap into action.
That woke him up.
Oh, I did. Okay, so I think I'm going to do another one of. I don't have that many videos, as I say. It's. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 left. So there aren't that many videos, but we have got some live. So well, I'm going to.
Michelle hasn't come up with one yet, has she?
No, she hasn't. So Michelle, put your thinking cap on, and let me know which one you'd want to add to this. So Jeff, I'm going to put the one you had listed as number 2. Do you remember what that one was?
No.
True Love.
Oh, speaks for itself. Sorry, yeah. It's the old from the film, Bing Crosby, I think Grace Kelly. They were on a boat when they sang it. So it's from a musical, but it's an instrumental version of True Love.
Oh, good, cool. I've just, don't know if anyone else has got things popping up on their phone, but Boris Johnson has resigned as MP.
Really?
Yeah, apparently, dramatically, let's just according to the headline.
I wouldn't even have given him that time, to be honest.
No. So, the only comment I have for that is good.
Was it something we said?
Apparently, he's resigned on receipt of the investigation report.
Ha! Well, is that another way of saying you're sacked?
No, Ian, it means it's a way of saying I'm guilty.
Yeah, absolutely.
Isn't it? That's what it looks like.
And Nadine Dorris has gone. So,
yeah, I think she's gone in a huff, though, because she wasn't on Boris's list. Oh, well, he didn't give me a peerage.
In that case.
This is nearly as much entertainment as the tunes.
Can we keep going at them? Can we go kind of like Python-esque? Can we go up to the House of Parliament and say, your mother was a hamster and your father was a hamster?
Do you know what I saw? I did see, I know this is digressing a little bit from Jeff's tune, which I'm going to play in a second, but I did see a fabulous meme on Facebook earlier today that said, everyone needs to find someone who looks at them the same way as Nadine Dorries looks at the person she's hoping to give them a peerage. And there's this photograph of her doing the whole bring it, Boris.
I think Nadine Dorries wants more than a peerage of Boris Johnson.
Oh, my goodness. You don't think she wants his baby to do it?
Stone for my eyes. That's a hideous image that just popped into my head.
Has anybody heard of Reginald D. Hunter?
Yes. In Carlisle,
he said, talk about kind of going, he said, Margaret Thatcher. He says, I didn't like her. I didn't like a lot of her ideals, but you've got to stand by somebody who stood by their ideals. And he said, and this the woman said, she got all pissy with me and said, Madonna, she's a proper woman's woman. And he said, no, excuse me, but he said, Margaret Thatcher got where she was by her brain. She didn't have to wiggle her ass to get to the top. And I thought, oh yeah, that's fair enough. She said, and he said, she'd never have to suck nobody's dick. And I went, oh, no!
He was brilliant, though, Reginald D. Hunter, because we saw him at the fire station in Carlisle. He was doing a pre-show thing a couple of years ago before he actually started on a proper tour, and he was wonderful. He was so funny.
Yeah, and so sort of still.
Oh, yeah.
You know, he's sort of like so grounded in himself.
Yeah, irreverent.
Sorry, I've got to tell you this because it's just, this is a true musician's, Jeff knows it, because we were coming back from choir and more, it was a beautiful still night and we were going up towards Prospect and long straight road, nothing, and Maureen said, fancy those silly old buggers going back on tour. I said, what? And I was sort of like, and a half, what? And she said, those silly old buggers, she said, going out on the road at their age with all their money. And I said, who are you talking about? She says, ABBA. Going down the road. I've had this this whole thing about Benny and Bjorn trying to get the transit through the MOT with his dog. Sorry.
Right, I was going to say we've digressed now, though, because I was going to say I don't know how appropriate this title of this track is now, Jeff, after what we've been talking about. But yeah, so this is True Love.
Count Boris in on that.
Great. Lovely. Thanks for sending that in. That's really nice to hear you playing the steel, just you. It's so often kind of a bit buried, and I can't, you know, it's nice to just hear that clean, pure sound. It's lovely. Okay, so we're going to come to Ian. Are you ready, Ian? You're muted at the minute.
Yeah, the guitar's tuned to what Jeff was playing because it wasn't in tune, so I try to pull it out of the case. So I hope you were in tune because I'm in tune with you now, Jeff.
Never the best instrument to tune to, the steel guitar, with its moving fret situation. Never mind.
It reminded me of the lost chord. That one.
No, I like those chords, Ian. I have to say I'm a bit of a sucker for those.
Yeah.
I like demented chords.
I was going to play the choir. Oh, the choir's got a wedding. I've got a wedding tomorrow, and I'm playing at it. And I said, you do have a photographer. Who's the photographer? And they said, you. So no pressure. I'm playing, accompanying the choir, providing the backing music, and I'm doing the photography.
Good luck.
Yeah, it's no pressure.
You're going to be the best man there, right?
Has anybody got anything they want to hear? Because I haven't actually got anything. I was trying to think of something, and all I can think of is all the stuff that I usually do. How long is it since I did Maryport Blues?
a while, I think. I would quite happily hear Blue Cloudless Skies.
Oh, right. Oh,
Borderlands. I would quite fancy hearing anything Randy Newman.
A Silith song.
Oh, wow. How kind of you.
No, I just lost for suggestions now.
Okay, yeah. I'm going to do Maryport Blues simply because the choir decided that there's a line in it that was disrespectful to LGBT plus community, and they might be offended by it, and so they all suggested alternative lines for it, and they didn't kind of like work out the fact that the bloke who wrote it might be offended by them actually trying to change it for some fictitious or hypothetical person of the LGBT plus community who might misinterpret the words because it was never meant to be.
Right, quite right.
And as the last, as a white Caucasian, no, you are a Caucasian if you're white, as a Caucasian male, I'm the only one that everybody can have a pop at without sort of like fear of recrimination. So this has got a line in it that if any of you of the LGBT plus community are offended by "Don't Be" because it doesn't refer to you, unless you're further along the keyboard, you know, because they've run out of letters now, so they're into the apostrophes and the the mathematical symbols, plus, minus, equals. I identify as a semicolon because I've always been a bit of an ass.
Excellent. I love that.
Where the Solway Firth meets the Irish Sea, there's a feisty kind of attitude and some serious history. If you dress to impress and wear your dancing shoes, come on down to Maryport Blues. Get yourself to Maryport Blues. The sun's going down in a western sky, dancing on the water and dazzling the eyes of the crowd on the quayside, admiring the views who've come along to Maryport Blues. They're coming down to Maryport Blues. The crowds are inviting, no, bars are fighting to meet the demand. The girls are inviting the boys in the band to get them a place at the head of the queue and get them into Maryport Blues. Squeeze them into Maryport Blues. You know you could use a tonic. What do you got to lose? Get on it. Open the mic, Philharmonic Blues. Down by the quayside, the evening light. Diner's got a fella thinking dynamite. Be clearing for action, igniting her fuse. He'll be going off at Maryport Blues. Fireworks at Maryport Blues. Dancing, rocking, so rolling, swaying. No cars can find the way in. On every street they're playing blues. Juan Le Pen, Saint-Tropez, but the festival at Maryport blows them away. Where the men are all men, some of the women are too. You never know at Maryport Blues. See them all at Maryport Blues. Ski you down at Maryport, Maryport, Scaryport. Get yourself to Maryport Blues.
Yay!
Yay. Oh, I love it.
Did you spot the unintentional slight?
No.
Oh!
But you're supposed to!
Oh, really?
Yes. Because some people might take exception to the fact that the men are all men and some of the women are too.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I heard that. I didn't think of that as a slide. I just thought that was a matter of fact.
It's nothing to do with the gender affiliation. It was to do with the muscular structure of the women.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, there's some...
Hey, I've played Mary Porter as well, Ian.
What I loved was it was July in Maryport. The wind was the rain and the wind was horizontal, and they were still in the strappy tops. It was Baltic. Counting out.
The Geordie lasses have got nothing on them, mate.
I tell you what. There is one group of people who are even a notch above the Geordies in terms of going out with, you know, in Baltic weather. Children in winter in the playground. You cannot get them to put a coat on or keep a coat on.
Unless it's the middle of summer now.
In the middle of summer, they sit there and they say, oh, it's cold. And they're sweating.
Au contraire.
But in the middle of winter, you cannot see a bloody coat in sight. It's ridiculous.
I do a bit of cycling, and this weather at the moment, when the sun goes in, the wind comes down from the north, and it's really cold.
It's cold,
and the sun comes out again, and you don't know what to wear. And I was driving along, this guy yesterday, and he was wrapped up so tight that he could hardly move on his bike, and then he had a rain cape on the top of it. A bright yellow rain cape. You never know.
Are you sure it wasn't just a portable sauna? Could have been.
There you go.
Brilliant. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Right, so Neil, I'm going to set you up again for the next one after our next video. Okay, so I haven't heard anything from Tony, and he wasn't absolutely sure he was going to drop in or be able to drop in, but he did manage to upload a video. So I think we'll play that one next. And Tony has agreed as well to doing the concert in October. So that makes, I think it's four of you. So we'll be able to split time a little bit more, and then maybe even have like a dedicated collaboration section at the end if you like. So yeah, this is Green Green Grass. He's actually named it for the first time ever, I think. Green Green Grass from Tony.
The old hometown looks the same as I step down from the train. There to meet me is my mama and my papa. Down the road I look, and there runs Mary. Hair of gold and lips like cherries. It's good to touch the green, green grass of home. Yes, they'll all come to meet me. Arms reaching, smiling sweetly. It's good to touch the green, green grass of home. The old house is still standing, though the paint is cracked and dry. And there's that old oak tree that I used to play on. Down the lane I walk with my sweet Mary. Hair of gold and lips like cherries. It's good to touch the green, green grass of home. When I wake and look around me at the four gray walls that surround me, and I realize, yes, I was only dreaming. And there's a garden, there's a saddle, padre, on an older walk at daybreak again. I'll touch the green, green grass of home. guess they'll all come to see me in the shade of that old oak tree, as they lay me neath the green, green grass of home.
It's lovely to hear. Lovely to hear Tony again.
Such a simple, lovely song, that.
Yeah, do you know, I really picked up my guitar then and just actually played
it. I've just been playing the keyboard again.
It's great, though. It's just a good thing no one else can hear it.
Oh, yeah, but just as well.
It's just fun. It's just fun. It's like busking along with someone. It's brilliant. No, it's good. Yeah. Especially with my new system here now, so it sounds good.
Yeah, it's also been ruined for me by somebody who couldn't pronounce his R's.
What?
He wanted to sing it in a club.
I see.
He said, and then I wake and look around me, the four grey walls that surround me, and I realise, yes, I was only dreaming. And he'd been set up. He'd been set up so they were all shoving hankies into the mouths in their audience.
Oh. That's quite sad, really.
Wasn't that Only Fools and Horses?
No, that was another song, but it was exactly, it was Quying.
Quying, yay!
Elise, what do we...
Wonderful, wonderful. Quying, yay!
Excuse me, we have got a Brian, sir. We have got a Brian.
Elise, what do we... now, I'm sorry, I've just had a brain fog moment. Where were we?
Michael.
Neil, that's where we were. We're going to come back to Neil. I was going to say, just before you start, Neil, so Tony has had a pretty rough few months. He is still commuting backwards and forwards to his dad's to clear the house and things, having lost him only a couple of months ago. Mm-hmm. And then he lost another family member recently as well. So he's having a really fairly crappy time of it at the minute. But having said that, he has agreed to do October, and he sort of said that my little message had spurred him on and he dug that out. So I'm hoping, he said he was hopeful to get back to do some music soon. So he might still join us, hopefully, fingers crossed. But so I think we'll be seeing him soon anyway. Neil, over to you.
Oh, okay. I was miles away there. That's it, Ian. You know, you were saying about you were concerned about people taking offence.
Yes. I was told that people.
No. I think I'd be more concerned if they came back and took the gate as well.
Knew that was coming. Well, there's a guy who said that he put electric fences all round his garden.
You know something? I took it by accident. I took the cat's medicine, you know. I just took the cat's medicine, eh?
As you do.
Yeah. Don't ask me how, but I did.
Oh, no. What I was going to say was the guy put a big electric fence all around his own property and his neighbours were dead against it.
I kind of lost the, what is it, the will to live now. I think I was going to do some things like deep and meaningful, but I don't know whether to do that now. Oh, bollocks, I will do. Okay. This old house is falling down around my ears. I'm drowning in a river, my own tears. Gone, you hold me sway. and I need you at the dimming of the day. You pull me like the moon pulls on the tide. I know just where I keep my better side. Ooh, ooh. What fates have come to keep us far apart? A broken promise or a broken heart? All those bonnie birds have wheeled away, and I need you at the dimming of the day. Come the night, you're the only one I want. Come the night, you could be my confidant.
I really love your version of that, Neil. Yeah, yeah, brilliant. Very, very. You've got till October to polish it.
I've just had an epiphany. Fortunately.
I'm a bit dehydrated.
I hope you clear it up afterwards.
I think we should do our very own transatlantic sessions. Do you know what I'm on about?
I'm not going over there for anybody, mate.
Loch Lomond. We all go to Loch Lomond. No, just playing there with Neil, it was just so nice. And
playing
with Tony, and nobody hears him. No, you know, there's only me. He hears me playing with Tony, and there's only me playing with you. And I think it'd be lovely to meet somewhere and just play as musicians, just with an audience or without an audience. I don't give a stuff. I just want to play among ourselves.
You just want to interfere, don't you? And everybody. So do I.
Yeah, but I like.
You wouldn't let it lie, would you?
I like to interfere with people, but you're safe, Geoffrey.
I'm bloody pleased to hear it, pal.
Oh dear.
am I the only one? I mean, I really.
No, you're absolutely right, Ian. You're absolutely right.
You know, you meet somewhere like Silith on a summer's evening on the press and just play with each other. Just meet up and just play for the love of playing.
Play with each other on the green. That says I'll
play with each other. Who's going to be the equal sign of the LGBT plus semicolon dash?
Well, if you want a sort of a venue in between the two of you, we could always meet at my house as long as you don't mind a fiddle scratching along in the background. Very out of practice.
Nah, we don't want to do that.
Nah.
Yeah, that'd be nice. That'd be a nice idea. Yeah.
Well, do you know what? This is all sorts of things that I'm really looking forward to and get up there. And these are the
These
are the kind of things that I'm, you know, looking forward to, being able to be involved in stuff and get myself out there and do things rather than stuck in my flat.
By the way, Ian, I don't know if you've been to Silith lately, but it is not green. It is like nearly a shade of white.
Really?
I've never seen it like it. Well, I don't think I've ever seen it like it, full stop. But there's people in the town are saying, oh, yeah, I've seen it like it before. Not in June. No way.
Right.
It's really, there's like bits of, there's like sand now. There's not even grass on it. It's like
gosh.
So, yeah. It's pretty, we need rain desperately, actually. So.
The old farmer's saying, which is like rain in May, plenty of hay. And I think we're on that situation now, where we're
just, really dry,
It's unbelievable.
Yeah. Right, so I've just had a message from Sandy. I know you've got to disappear fairly soon, Sandy. She's got things going on. Busy today. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to swap Sandy to go next, if that's all right with you, Dad, and then you after that. Sandy, is that all right with you? I don't know.
I don't have anything set up.
Oh, okay. I've got a video first, though.
All right.
Does that give you time?
Yeah.
Okay, right. I'm going to play a video. We're going to get one more out of you. okay, so I think what I'm going to do, I think I've found Rhiannon's song, but it is just labelled Rhiannon, so I'm hoping it's the right one. So we'll play that next. Michelle, did you want to say anything about this one?
Not really.
That's a lot of effort. Well, other than the fact that she wrote it.
Oh, yeah,
if it's the right one, have you ever done Rhiannon?
Yeah.
Yeah. As opposed to Rhiannon's song.
Well, we've never done like the Fleetwood Mac Rhiannon.
You haven't? Okay. Then it's got to be the right one, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's got to be. Yeah. And I mean, Michelle wrote this, and it's a lovely song. And I actually thought it would be applicable for young Jacob there.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. So, yeah, it's a lovely song. It's a nice song.
Anything to add to Michelle?
No.
No, just play it.
I guess. So, yeah.
Okay, right. I'll just play it then.
For one so small, you seem so strong with a power in your eyes to right every wrong. When I first saw you and when I held you, the worry of life's burdens melted away. Know you are cherished, know you are loved through endless time. A tiny heart that fills the hole in mine. I know you can't turn back the time, and there are things you you can't replace. Buckshot tiny heart fills the hole in mine. You darling child, precious wonder, an image of perfection laid in my arms. When I see you and when I hold you, all my grief and sorrow disappear. Know you are cherished, know you are loved through endless time. A tiny heart that fills the hole in mine. I know you can't turn back the time, and there are things you can't replace, but your tiny heart fills the hole in mine. Tiny heart that fills the hole in mine. I know you can't turn back the time, and there are things you can't replace, but your tiny heart fills the hole in mine. Know that your tiny heart fills the hole in mine.
That's lovely, Michelle. Really gorgeous.
Beautifully put together, Jeff. I take it was you who produced it.
Yeah. Well, I'm sitting here with tears in my eyes. I nearly turned the camera off just then, but yeah.
Wasn't that bad?
Fabulous, no. Well, I am. Yeah, I'm a bit of a wreck.
It was a beautiful production and nice harmonies, but nicely balanced. It was just gorgeous. Well,
yeah. Yeah, just well done, Michelle, though. I mean, I couldn't, you know, I mean, I produced it, but I couldn't have done it without Michelle's voice. Just wonderful.
It was big props to Michelle for writing such a beautiful and straight from the heart, too.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. And as I say, applicable to Jacob as well, you know, so it's like just any baby, you know.
Yeah.
And I mean, the line, filling the hole in my heart, you know, it's kind of just, yeah.
Yeah.
Lovely. I think I'll just mute now.
Yeah. Lovely. Beautiful song, Michelle.
Thanks.
Okay, we're gonna get another one from Sandy, and I have just heard from Shauna, who hopefully will be dropping in soon, so it might be that Shauna and Sandy pass like ships. Yeah.
He's only on the other side of the city.
Did you just start to say ships that pass in the night?
That is not what I said.
we'll see you on the sky train.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's a hard song to follow.
Sorry.
Beautiful. Anyway, I'm going to sing a Canadian song. It's written by a teacher who used to teach in Surrey, British Columbia, not Surrey, England. It's called The Last Battle. And it's a historic event, true story. An east wind blew in the storms of time, where the Métis lived on the winding river. For on a steel rail the settlers came to the south of Saskatchewan, and the land they claimed. Then three matey and Gabrielle rode like the wind to wild Montana and on the sweet grass in a church of stone. They found their savior and they took him home, saying, come, Riel, we'll make a stand here at Batoche beside the river. Oh, never mind their Gatling gun. If we lose this time, we've lost forever. Then the bullets flew and the cannons roared and the matey blood flowed like a river into the coulees where they ran to hide. It washed their dreams away and their spirits died. Then a silence fell across the land. The guns of war were gone forever. But in the starlight on a barren plain, the cry of Gabrielle flies on the wind. Oh, come, Riel, we'll make a stand here at Batoche beside the river. Oh, never mind their Gatling gun. If we lose this time, we've lost forever. Oh, come, Riel, we'll make a stand here at Batoche beside the river. Oh, never mind their Gatling gun. If we lose this time, we've lost forever. But for one more time, let's stand together.
Yeah, great stuff.
Very good.
Brilliant, Sandy. Lovely.
Yeah. Fab. Really good. Thank you, Sandy. And I know we have to lose you soon, but yeah. Shauna made it before you left. Hi, Shauna. Hi, Tony. Good to see you both.
Oh, hi, Shauna.
Sandy, the blue-haired beauty from Canada.
It's been so good to see you again, Sandy. I know you said you probably can't make August.
No, we're away with grandkids.
What's the one after August? October. Yeah. So maybe October?
Maybe.
Hopefully. Maybe. Lovely. Well, that'd be good to see you again anyway.
Have a good summer, everybody.
Hello. You too. Take care.
We're all joined together.
Bye, Sandy.
I'll be your blue-haired beauty from Canada.
Oh, shut up, man. Goodness sake, man. Give me a rest, eh?
I don't know what other colours I've got in there because it's going to show up the blue.
Nobody's actually. Bye, Sandy. Nobody's actually noticed that I've ditched the red this month. Look. So, I got a bit fed up of it fading so quickly and looking very grey very quickly. So I'm hoping this is going to last a little bit longer. But anyway, I can always.
Now you come to mention it, yeah. I'll see. It blends in well with the cans, you know.
It does, actually, yeah, yeah.
What could happen, black cans, if you got red hair?
Here you came, though. I haven't had to get my highlights done in months because all my grey's coming in now.
Oh, hello, Shauna.
Hello, everyone. Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you.
Yeah. Feels like it's been forever.
It does, doesn't it? It does. We've had a couple of that have been quite low in numbers. I mean, they've been cracking. We've had a great time, but it's been quite low in numbers. And then tonight, I feel like there's a few more people here, which is lovely. So,
I'm enjoying it immensely, I have to say.
Let's take a quick break and have a bit of a chat, and then we'll come back. So, yeah, talk amongst yourselves. Yeah. Okay, so shall we crack on then? So obviously I put Sandy in before Dad, so Dad is up next. But what I was thinking I would do is play a video first to get us going, and then Dad to do yours.
Can I just ask, can I do a quick little song, and then I'll have to get away, I have to go, you see.
What, now?
Yeah, she's back in the kitchen, and that's always a bad sign.
Yeah, go on then. So, okay, then we'll come back with you as alive and then Dad then. That's no problem.
It's only a very short song. When you need someone, you can turn to, honey, don't you know? You can turn to me. Someone that you can hold on to, honey, don't you know? No, you can hold on me because you've given me the moon. But this you're unaware, you've been moving on so soon. Good night, my sweet angel. It's time to close your eyes. Good night, my sweet angel. I'll see you when you rise. Good night.
Oh, can I mute? That's lovely. Who's that by?
The Rembrandts.
Ah, okay, yeah. Thought it was familiar.
Yeah.
Love it. Right, yeah.
I'm gonna scoot because I've got to go get a shower off and shave. Hey,
enjoy the pub. I will keep you posted for the next one, but like I say, it won't probably be the second week in August. It'll probably be the third.
Well, I'm retired, so I don't have weeks.
Cool. All right. See you soon, Neil. Take care. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Neil.
Fab. Okay, Dad, we'll come to you then now.
Do you want to? Or am I going to be too bleak here? I wonder about that. But
you need to come closer to your microphone again, though, because you're quiet.
Well, I'm just saying, do you want mind in two or three? How's your plan going?
Well, you and Ian have only done one each so far.
If you want me, but I don't want to do... Some of this stuff is quite bleak in the end.
Okay. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4... I've got 5 videos left. So I'm thinking you and Ian will have at least another couple. I reckon you'll have done 3 by the end at least.
I'll do 2 then, all right? I'll do another 2, yeah.
Cool, okay.
Okay, so this is still Creon trying to persuade. Am I all right for volume?
Yeah.
Creon trying to persuade Antigone not to do what she's doing, which is to carry on. She's concerned. She's really determined to make herself a kind of martyr for this. And he says, "You've cast me for the villain in this little play of yours, and yourself for the heroine. But don't drive me too far. If I were a tyrant, you would be lying in a ditch this minute, with your tongue pulled out and your body mutilated. I have plenty of things to do today without wasting my time on you, but I'm not going to let politics get in the way of your be your cause of your death. For this is nothing but politics. I am fastidious. If it were up to me, I should have had them bury your brother long ago as a matter of public health. In the evening, when the breeze comes in off the sea, you can smell it in the palace. and it nauseates me. But I refuse even to shut my window. It's vile and it's stupid. But the people of Thebes have got to have their noses rubbed in it a little bit longer. That stench has to fill the town for a whole month. And she says, yeah, and that's awful. And, you know, kind of, I'm feeling how awful it is, really, with Creon's point of view, because I can quite sympathise with him. And when she says, well, you know, you didn't have to do it. And he says, yes, I did. There had to be somebody who said yes. There had to be somebody to agree to captain the ship. She had sprung 100 leaks. She was loaded to the waterline with crime, ignorance, poverty. The wheel was swinging in the wind. The crew refused to work and were looting the cargo. The officers were building a raft, ready to slip overboard and desert the ship. The masts were splitting. The wind was howling. The sails were beginning to rip. Everyone on board was about to drown. And only because the only thing they thought of was their own skins. Was that time, do you think, for playing with words? Was that time to weigh the pros and cons, wondering if it wasn't going to be too high a price to pay later on? Now, you grab the wheel. You right the ship in the face of a mountain of water. You shout an order, and if one man chooses to obey, you shoot straight into the mob. The beast as nameless as the wave that crashes down on the deck, as nameless as the whipping wind. The thing that drops when you shoot. Maybe someone who poured you a drink the night before. But it has no name. And you, braced at the wheel, you have no name either. Nothing has a name.
Four. Yeah. Yeah, very dark.
Yeah.
It's darker.
Oh, God. Oh. Right.
Can we have some Leonard Cohen?
Oh, dear. No, I tell you what, though, I'm going to play something a little bit more cheery. I'm going to play mine and Dad's song. I don't think I've played this for a while, so I'm hoping it's not too stale.
Dance.
Ten Cents Dance.
Brilliant. Love it.
I work at the palace ballroom, but gee, that palace is cheap. When I get back to my chilly hall room, I'm much too tired to sleep. I'm one of those lady teachers, a beautiful hostess, you know, the kind the palace features at exactly a dime a throw. 10 cents a dance, that's what they pay me. Gosh, how they weigh me down. 10 cents a dance, fancies and rough guys, tough guys who tear my gown. 7 till midnight, I hear drums, loudly the saxophone blows. Trumpets are tearing my eardrums. Customers crush my toes. Sometimes I think I found my hero, but it's a queer romance. All the
10 cents a dance. Fighters and sailors and bow-legged tailors can pay for a ticket and rent me. Butchers and barbers and rats from the harbours, sweethearts my good love has sent me. Though I've a chorus of elderly beaux, stockings are porous with holes in the toes, I'm here till closing time. Dance and be merry, it's only a dime. 10 cents a dance, that's what they pay me. Gosh, how they weigh me down. 10 cents a dance, fancies and rough guys, tough guys who tear my gown. 7 till midnight I hear drums, loudly the saxophone blows. Trumpets are tearing my eardrums, customers crush my toes. Sometimes I think I found my hero, but it's a queer romance. All that you need is a ticket. Come on, big boy, 10 cents a dance.
Can't find the unmute button again.
That was right. It was like a treat watching you actually singing along with it, doing like a little...
Brilliant. Was I out of time for you?
No, you're all right. You're bang on. No problem.
I haven't played that one for a while, I think. So it's another one of the ones that I don't cringe too badly when I'm listening to it. But I was singing along there and went, tough guys who wear my gown rather than tear my gown. that changes it altogether.
Back to the LGBT plus community.
Yes. So it changes the lyrics completely because then it's a queer romance.
I'm offended.
Oh, dear. Anyway. Right, so who are we up to next? Ian, we're back to you.
Me?
I didn't give you a standby, I'm really sorry. Do you want me to play another video?
Well, I've got... you asked for Blue Cloud of Skies, and I'm playing it at a wedding tomorrow.
Oh, cool.
It'd be a really good idea if I rehearsed it.
Not a bad idea at all. By the way, how is Maureen? We haven't seen her this evening.
She's knackered, but it's I'm a wee bit lacking in sympathy because she went out at 10:30 with a friend and came back and rang me at 3:00 to say the bus hasn't come, so will you come and get me? And then the bus came, so she said, will you come and get me? And then she said, right, well, we need to go into town now for some pet food supplies and my prescriptions. And then when we got back, she says, I'm absolutely knackered.
For a minute, I thought you were saying she'd gone out at 10 o'clock at night and come back in 3 in the morning.
So she's, I'm not sure quite where she is. I think she's probably complaining about me. I'll just haul this over. My piano forte. Am I still in focus? Do you care?
Yeah, you know, you're still there.
Can you hear that?
Yeah.
Yep.
Not too loud.
Difficult to tell from one note.
So this is a slightly different version because we play the choir. The choir plays the first sings the first verse. And then the bride comes down the aisle. It's a nice story because it's Leah's mother. I don't know if you remember Leah Stevenson. She's been dead, died at 16. But it's just 5 years since she died. And her mother kept coming to choir because it kept her kind of like half sane. And another guy called John came because he'd lost his wife and he was suffering. And the pair of them got together and a romance has bloomed out of it. And getting married tomorrow. So isn't that?
Oh, that's lovely.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
And they've asked for this. This is for because Leah obviously is still very much in everyone's mind.
Yeah. So that might be a little bit loud, the piano. Yeah, that sounds good. Yeah, lovely.
Am I balanced up?
Yes, I think so.
Okay. It's one of those days when everything falls right into place. One of those days when I can't seem to find a smile on my face and I'm sorry if I seem to lack sympathy for what's on your back. It seems so long since I got back on the track, but now I'm looking at blue cloudless skies. Blue cloudless skies. Hard to realize something that's just right in your face, vanished and gone without a trace, and all that's left in their place are blue cloudless skies. I'd love to help, but I'm a meanness nerd. I'm not your salvation. Not often that I feel this way, but tonight's the day, today's the day. And there might be hell to pay tomorrow, but meanwhile today I got blue cloudless skies. Blue cloudless skies. It's hard to realize troubles that stick right in my face, vanished and gone without a trace, and all that's left in that place are blue cloudless skies. Blue cloudless skies. It's hard to realize troubles that stick right in my face, vanished and gone without a trace, all that's left in their place are blue cloudless skies. Blue cloudless skies.
Good song. Good
song. Yeah, that's a lovely version of that as well. Okay. Really nice. Yeah,
very
that's
appropriate.
Such a killer key change, that, Ian. It's one of the most subtle key changes I think I've heard. That's
like,
really
like
well.
A cricket bat on the back of the head.
Talking of key changes, my poor kids, we've been learning last half term, we were learning their music. They learn a song each time as well as other things, doing other things. And they were learning to sing "He's Got the Whole World in His Hand," which is a song that I absolutely hate anyway. So it didn't help, but at least it was a reasonable gospel version of it. It wasn't kind of one of these like, you know, anyway. The version that they were learning, it had about four key changes in it. By the time we got to the end, it was so high that dogs were like outside the classroom. That was ridiculous. It started far too low for their seven-year-old voices and ended up somewhere in the gods. It was horrendous.
While we're on the subject, I've got yesterday we do sunbeams, which is for people with various mental conditions and learning difficulties. And there's a guy who's obsessed with Bond films. and we tried to accommodate him. So we he did, and I've forgotten the name of it. It was one of those really obscure Bond things. I don't know if anybody's ever had to play Bond themes, but some of them are really, really flipping weird. And so we all kind of contacted each other and decided what key to it. And I'm trying to remember. It was after Skyfall. It was one of the really bizarre songs, and we learnt it anyway. And we went yesterday, and we said, "Right, what would you like? Do you want to do James Bond?" He said, "No, Louis Armstrong." we have all the love in the world.
Absolutely brilliant.
Sorry, wrong register there, Ian.
No, you're not. You're doing bloody Skyfall, you get.
Oh dear. Have you seen Stephen recently? Because he hasn't been on online for a while.
I saw him the other week. He's not coming at the moment. He's got lots of health issues around his. I don't want to talk to him. He passes out.
Right.
Yeah. And it's part of an epileptic, some part of the epileptic sort of spectrum. And the last time he hit his head really badly, because he just went over, straight over backwards.
Ouch.
He was on a bench, you know, like a wooden bench. And I have spoken to him, and he seems okay, but if he wasn't, he wouldn't tell me.
No. Well, next time you see him, can you say hi from all of us? I assume everybody would pass on their best wishes to him.
He'd be thrilled.
Yeah, so please say we were asking after him and said hello.
Yeah, because just yesterday I was on about this, that they don't have there's a kind of like thing that they don't have a voice. One of my... I get into trouble for kind of like going up to them and doing face and I see you, I know you're in there. I know you're in there. And sometimes they kind of like, it freaks them out because they're what the hell?
Not used to people listening to them.
That's right. You know, and so to know that he's actually acknowledged as a human being on the planet is really, really important to him. Sorry, I get passionate about this because
as far as I'm concerned, he's every single bit as much of a member of our Zoom family as everybody else. Mm. So, I like to check in and see how people are doing. And he's we haven't seen him for a while, so please let him know we're asking after him.
He's a lovely fella, but yeah. So many of them are. There's a guy, he's rich. I call him Fascinating Facts, because if you say to a song, we'll do such a song, Sweet Caroline, you know, it's not exactly the world's most difficult, but it'll tell you the history.
Right.
It was first recorded in 1992 on such and such a label. And can we do it now?
Brilliant. Brilliant.
I love it.
Yeah. Okay, so the next, well, Neil was on my list next, and obviously he's in the pub, so he's not doing the next one. So I think we're down to you and Daddy. And so I've got, what have I got left in my little folder here? I've got one more from Colin. I have got one from you, Ian, and two from Jeff. So.
Sounds like a Jeff.
Do we want...
Because mine are bleak and we can...
Well, I'm just thinking, do we want to do... So we could do one, Dad. What we could do is we could do one now, then you, Dad, then two, and then Ian.
Right.
To finish up, if that's what you think.
If he's a bleak, I'll do italic.
Oh, <my goodness. laughs> Oh dear. Okay, so what I think I'm going to do, that sounds like a bit of a plan then, doesn't it? Should we do that? So if you've got one more each, what we'll do is we'll play yours now, Ian, and then we'll do Dad, and then we'll have two. Oh, hang on a minute. Yeah, we'll do put two in the middle, Colin's and one of Jeff's, and then we'll do, oh, that won't work. Look, I need to do two now and two after Dad, and then Ian to finish up and play us out.
Right, okay.
Yeah, does that sound, that sounds like it, doesn't it? Okay, so let's do, I'm going to do, Jeff, I'm going to do yours first. Number three was Lion. Do you want to explain that one?
Yeah. So it's a, I mean, I don't know if anyone's familiar with the American guitarist, John Fahey. Well, I used to call him John Fahey, but F-A-H-E-Y. And I have to say that I'm totally distracted by Michelle and the baby. This is more entertaining than anything else. It's such a lovely baby, really is. Yeah, he's wonderful. But anyway, sorry. Yes, this is actually I did this way back. It was actually always one of Sarah's favourites, and she always wanted me to be playing it now. And I would struggle, to be perfectly honest, with my fingers the way they are these days. But so I'm pleased I actually managed to get this down, recorded. So, yeah, it's just simply a tune called Lion. And it's sort of dynamic. It kind of switches around a bit in its feel and things. So I just hope you like it. Mummy and I do still, you know.
Fabulous.
Thank you.
Ah, superb.
Brilliant.
Fabulous, Jeff.
Me definitely finishing off with a keyboard song now.
Ah, Jacob was clapping there. That's the main thing.
He loved it.
That was absolutely brilliant. Really good.
John Fair called that, I think it was the Stars called American Primitive. Now, anybody who's tried to play it wouldn't call it primitive, would they?
It's
so complicated.
Yeah.
You need the thumb and finger independence, don't you, to be able to play that?
Yeah, I saw him live on an occasion, and just on one occasion, he was pissed as a fart.
Well, he was a thing, wasn't he?
Yeah, it was a thing with John Fay, but he was absolutely brilliant. Once someone shouted out from the audience, "Are you gonna play us a song?" You know, it was like after about 20 minutes on stage of drinking and rambling on, but he was absolutely wonderful. And I mean, he was such an influence on me, I have to say. You know, brilliant, just wonderful.
Yeah, fab, really, really good.
Good night, Kate. So to everybody, so I have to go. So
okay, Tony.
Catch you all soon.
Good night, Tony.
Yeah.
And take care, everybody.
Good night,
Tony. Thanks for joining us, Tony. It's been brilliant to see you.
Yeah. Lovely. Thanks. See you soon.
See you soon again. Yeah. Take care, my love.
Bye.
Bye. Okay, so what we'll do is I'm going to put in the second. No, actually, I'm going to put in. I'm saving yours, Colin, your final one. I'm going to put in Ian's submission. For this one. Ian, do you want to tell us about this one?
Yeah. I met her. Maureen and I were out with Duke down Armathwaite Woods, and we met this guy with a couple of dogs. One was a Norfolk Terrier called Dougal, and he showed me a picture of him on his bike, on his push bike, with a leather, with a helmet and a pair of dark glasses on. And I thought it was so cool that I had to make a video. And I've actually put the video of Dougal on the bike into an existing video. So you know the song, you've seen the video, and it's just a rehashed with Dougal in. And it's called Freewheeling, and it's got Dougal the Norfolk Terrier in. And he's just absolutely charmed the pants off everybody.
Excellent.
Yeah. Ride my bike in the peace and quiet, my own pace, my own space. You should try it. There's no pressure, even the wind and rain don't dampen the simple pleasure of riding down a country lane, freewheeling under a northern sky. Freewheeling, the miles go rolling by. I like to ride my bike in sunny weather. Get a shout if a pal comes out, then we ride together. But if I'm on my own, it's all the same to me. I don't mind being alone. I'm easy company. Freewheeling under the northern sky. Freewheeling, the miles go rolling by.
peace and quiet. No hurry, forget your worries, you should try it. Some days, sometimes, I stop to admire the view. I might be inclined to take a picture or two. Freewheeling under the northern sky. Freewheeling, the miles go rolling by. I like to ride my bike in the peace and quiet. No hurry, forget your worries, you should try it. There's no pressure, even wind and rain. Don't dampen the simple pleasure of riding down a country lane. Freewheeling under the northern sky. Freewheeling, the miles go rolling by. Freewheeling under the northern sky. Freewheeling, the miles go rolling by, rolling by.
Oh, I love that.
That's great. That's great.
He's so cool. He's a really cool dog.
I just love the daft dog with the glasses.
It was just brilliant. I love the dog.
Yeah.
He says he likes you. He likes everybody.
Amazing.
Dougal, come here, and he puts the helmet, all right, or whatever, you know. Put the helmet, you know. Duke could have eaten them all by it, you know. and half your hand as well.
Oh, amazing.
I put me on the bike, yeah, off we go. Maybe this is your best side, you know.
Love it. It's absolutely brilliant. Okay, Dad, we're going to come to you. To pull us down before Ian pushes us back up again at the end.
I've been down for it all the way. But so poor old Creon has one last try to get Antigone to give this up. This is really kind of sad. Everyone. Do you know what your brother was? He was a cruel, vicious little beast with just enough wit to drive a car faster and throw more money away than any of his pals. I was with your father one day when Polynices, having lost a lot of money gambling, asked him to settle this debt. And when your father refused, he hit him in the face with his fist. Your father sat at his desk with his head in his hands. I told you it was a tragedy. His nose was bleeding, he was weeping. And in the corner of his study, Polynices stood sneering and lighting a cigarette. Oedipus was too soft-hearted to have the boy locked up, so he was allowed to go into exile. And then the attempts upon your father's life began. One after another, men slipped into thieves for the purpose of assassinating him. And every killer we caught always end up by confessing who had put him up to it and paid him to try it. And it wasn't always Polynices. Eteocles was just as bad. That really is what I'm trying to tell you. Yesterday, I gave Eteocles a state funeral with full honours. Today, Eteocles is a saint and a hero in the eyes of all Thebes. the whole city turned out to bury him. What else could I have done? People had taken sides in a civil war. They couldn't both be wrong. That would have been too much. I couldn't have made them swallow the truth that Eteocles was just as rotten as Polynices. They were both engaged in selling out Thebes, and they died like the cheap gangsters they were over a division of the spoils. I sent out in the battlefield for their bodies. They were found clasped in one another's arms. First time in their lives, I imagine. Each was spitted on the other's sword. And the cavalry had trampled them down. They were mashed to a pulp. I had the prettier of the two corpses brought in and gave it a state funeral. And I left the other to rot. I don't know which was which. I don't care. Well, of course, that.
Very good, Dad.
Very good.
The prettier of the two corpses.
Yeah.
Yes, indeed.
Yes, very bleak. Thank you, Dad.
Happier next time.
Yes, please. Oh dear. Thank you for those. I'm quite looking forward to seeing, reading those or looking at those as potentials. Okay, I've got two videos left. And I'm thinking, Colin, time for your second one. So after all that bleakness, can we go back to Christmas? Do you want to say anything Christmas? About this one?
It's not that, well, it's a film theme from what, 1980, something like that. It's a tune by Ryuichi Sakamoto, who died, I think, early this year, I think. It's a nice tune. I've always wanted to play it and finally got around to it. Had to miss quite a few bits out to...
what film's it from?
It's in Merry Christmas, Mr. Lawrence.
Oh, it's that? That's the title of the film as well?
That's the title, yeah. It's a Japanese prisoner of war camp, and it's quite bleak. Okay. It's got David Bowie in, I think. It's,
all right. So not as cheery as I think it is, then?
No, it's not. No. It's a nice tune, though.
Okay, all right. Well, we're going to start with that one, then we'll come on to Last of Jeff's.
Thank you.
Oh, that's stunning as well. That's gorgeous, Colin.
Yes. Colin, that was can I ask you what kind of camera you're using?
A rubbish one, obviously. It kept going out. I don't know why it keeps going out of focus.
This is what I was going to say, because it's hunting, and you've got it. You've got it on autofocus.
Ah, right.
But you don't move, so it doesn't have to be. All you have to do is to set it to manual focus and set it to your ukulele. Right. And you won't do that anymore.
I've probably done that quite accidentally without realising I've changed the setting on it. Yeah.
I was second Ian's comments on that, yes.
That's beautiful. And as soon as you started, it hit that phrase, as like, oh, I know this.
Yeah.
I do know it. Yeah. And it really suits the ukulele. It was beautiful. Yeah, it really does.
Yeah, it's so sweet and so precise and so disciplined.
Yeah, yeah. It's a beautiful composer as well.
It's not terms normally applied to me, any of those, I have to say.
I think that needs to be on your album. Yes. That one, that needs to be on the CD.
Definitely, that's a good one. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I didn't ask before, Colin. Are you
gallery music? That's lovely as well.
Oh yeah, that one too. Yeah, Left Field. That was called, isn't it? Left Field, I think. Okay, so I'm going to play the last video that I have then, which is yours, Jeff. This one is, which one was this one? To Make You Feel My Love. Do you want to say anything about that one? Oh, you're muted.
Yeah. Not a lot, other than the fact that it's probably one of the most beautiful love songs written. And it was written by the king of songs, Bob Dylan. And this actually had a really lovely melody to it as well, because I never really thought Bob Dylan was, you know, really one for melodies, more for the poetry. Maybe a lot of other people think otherwise, but he wrote some great songs, but I think there were more poetry than actually songs. But this particular tune, I must admit, I was really shocked and stunned only a few years back when I realised that this was actually one of his. So, yeah, it's To Make You Feel My Love. Yeah, just an instrumental again, on the steel.
Cool. Thank you. Fabulous. Love that. That's brilliant. To hear it.
Okay.
Excellent. Thank you, Jeff. Right. So that's all the videos. We're left with a play out from Ian. Oh, you're muted, though. Helps if you unmute.
I was going to do May You Never, the John Martin, but when I heard Jeff play that, I thought, oh, bollocks to that.
No. You do it. That's a great song. Do it. Go for it.
Yeah, I'll do it next time because you asked for Silith Line, so it's your fault.
Blame me for everything. I don't care. I've got thick skin. Don't bother me, mate.
I'm sure I've told you before, but because of my age, I'm allowed to tell you again about the guy in the in Roadhead Village Hall. And I said, "This is this refers to an engine called 43139." And he called me afterwards. He says, "I think you'll find 43139 actually didn't run on the Silith Line. It actually ran on the Langham rails. Was it rails? It was a sort of like a particularly railway nerdy kind of song, it was sort of like Irons or whatever. You know, I think you'll find it ran on the Langham rails." And I went, oh. And I went away, and then there was a thing for the Cumberland News celebrating the end of the Silith Line, and there was a picture of 43139 pulling a train. And I don't know where he is because I want to...
Look!
Yeah. I'll tell you where he is, Ian. He is Sonia's boyfriend on EastEnders. Because that's exactly the voice you sounded like when you did that. Yeah. Okay, I'm a sad git. I watch EastEnders.
I think you'll find.
Yeah, that's him, exactly.
Next, if you ever bump into him again, you'll have to go back to him and go, I think you'll find. Oh, you were wrong. You'll find, yeah.
I have seen the video.
Oh, dear.
Dad said something.
Yeah, it's very quiet. Say again, Dad.
I have seen the video evidence.
Yes. Yes.
Talking about railways, my friend, we were cycled to Haltwhistle and we got the train back and he's given to kind of exact, precise descriptions. And he was sitting in this, you know, the trains that run from Newcastle to Carlisle, they're just dreadful. And he said, these carriages have such a bleak Soviet austerity to them. everybody else calls them crap. Such a bleak Soviet austerity. Good night for me. And we'd bought a cosy, smoky train at Carlisle Station. Engine number 43139, there it goes. And a holiday started at the moment when we'd steam off along the Silith Line. I need a yellow plastic windmill and a bucket and a spade. Ice cream cornets, candy floss and rock and lemonade. The sky was blue, the sea was clear. The sun shone every year as we'd roll along the Silith Line. I'd get half a crown from Auntie Mary and 2 and 6 and put 2 of me on. Mum and Dad might cough up the odd shilling, saying that will have to last till you get old, young man. Nowadays we holiday in Switzerland and Spain. We never seem to find the time to take the Silith train. Now they've taken up the track, but my memory takes me back to when we'd roll along the Silith Line. Thank you. the night at Kirkandrews on the site of the old Sabbath line. If you listen to the wind in the treetops, you can hear the ghost of 43139 with a yellow plastic windmill and a bucket and a spade, ice cream cornets, candy floss, milk and lemonade. The sky's blue, seems clear, the sun shone every year, and we rode along the Sillith, rode along the Sillith, we rode along the Sillith line.
Love it. Brilliant.
Frank Devine.
The Sillith Pines at the back of my garden.
Is it?
Yeah.
And is it still, does it still have trains going on it or not at all? Now no, is it just a clothesline?
There's cows and sheep on it now, so.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, and plus I don't want a train in my garden.
Oh, it's that close behind your house.
Yeah, wow, okay.
I did a workshop at Abbeytown School a few years ago, and the kids told me that the line went past their school, and I was absolutely stunned that they would think of such a thing, because I was so little and young, and it was all such a long time ago, but they all knew about the Sillith line.
Wow. That's quite impressive.
Yeah, we're just down the road from the school, so.
Yeah. All right.
So that just gave me images when you said that, Michelle, of, you know, there's like, I don't know whether it's one or there's several trains that go through small streets in China, and there's like stalls and marketplace and it's all buzzing and busy, and they get some kind of signal and everybody packs up and steps back into the recesses, and this train goes past like that far from their noses, and then it goes past and they put all their stuff out again and off they go.
Yeah.
There's video of it online. It's absolutely incredible. Yeah. Absolutely amazing.
Bangkok in Thailand. We almost went and saw that on our trip.
Oh, it's Thailand, not China. Okay, yeah. Amazing.
Near enough, it's foreign.
What's a country between friends?
Right.
So, it's incredible, isn't it? I had visions of that when you said it was running through your garden, Michelle. It's like, oh, pack up the paddling pool, the train is coming.
Health and safety. We couldn't help but notice there was a large train running through the playground.
Oh dear. Well, thank you all very much for joining us again. It's been lovely to see so many people back. It's been really nice to see sort of everybody back together again. And it's been really good fun. It's been a lovely night.
Oh, it has been fun. Thank you for having me.
You're very welcome. Thanks for joining us. And thanks for all your contributions as usual.
Sorry, do you want to just play out with this Darden Smith song, which you could then sort of like edit out of it because it's right at the end?
Yeah, sure. Absolutely. Just a few reminders before we hear that then. So I will be in touch about when the next virtual open mic will be, presumably the 18th, which I think is week 3. Is that what you said, Jeff?
Yeah, it is.
So hopefully it'll be that one. I hope that everything will be back to rights here and I will be free at that point and back in Cumbria permanently at that point. So that'll all be very exciting. But I will let you know, obviously. Okay. Well, as I was saying before, don't forget to spread the word for our series of concerts that we've got going on. Charlie Dore first. I know you said you might be interested in tickets for that, Ian.
Julian Lippmann.
Yeah. Sure.
And Julian Lippmann, yeah.
Yeah. I know... Julian seems quite a nice guy. Rick speaks highly of him. I've only met him the once. Well, I've only met Charlie Dore twice. So, and it was like 40 years apart.
Yeah.
So I'm not stalking her.
Oh, you aren't old enough for that, Ian.
What?
40 years apart.
Listen.
He's old enough for anything. What are you talking
about? Listen, I'm old enough for that.
I was in a studio and I've been told, in fact, and I believe that I'd recorded my first hit single. And I was in the office and Bruce Welch from The Shadows came in with Charlie Daw and they put the tape on and they put Pilot of the Airways on. And I thought, no, that's what a hit single sounds like.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. Not mine. That's what a hit single sounds.
Yeah, yeah. Anyway, so she's coming to the theatre, 26th, 28th, 28th of September. Yeah, so, yeah, I think you should. So anyway, yeah, spread the word, please, because I really need to launch this and we need to sell loads of tickets. Otherwise, we're not going to get people coming back because we're booking them on split ticket deals. So I need to make it worth their while and sell their tickets.
Can we call it John Peel Theatre Presents Rocktober, or is that too much?
Well, I'm calling it Folk at the John Peel, but I'm not sure that Charlie Daw fits entirely into that bracket.
You said it doesn't fit into Rocktober either.
No. But anyway, my official launch concert is John Kirkpatrick. That's kind of like the official Folk at the John Peel launch. Charlie then kind of got tagged on the beginning of it, but she's slightly not in the same category, but she sort of is as well. So yeah, but anyway. Push the word out, let everybody you know that might enjoy the concerts and tell them to book the tickets. They're all on sale now. So, yeah. Okay.
I've got a feeling that actually John Kirkpatrick's name is bigger than Charlie Dory.
In the folk world, I think probably true, yeah.
Producing some lovely music.
Yeah, yeah. But I think she has her own following as well. If you look at her Facebook page, it's like several thousand people follow her. She is already advertising our concert, so hopefully she'll bring a bit of her own following anyway. We'll see. Anyway, right, I love you and leave you all now. Thank you so much for joining me. We'll see you soon and see some of you in the flesh soon. Take care, everyone.
Okay, see you.
Lots of love.
Bye.
Bye, my lovelies.